dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And I do hope some of you were able to make it to our All About Dogs Day on June the 25th, basically last weekend at the Liberty Fire Company in Sinking Spring. It was an absolutely gorgeous day. The weather was perfect. We had a lot of exhibitors. The demonstrations were wonderful. We had a few vendors with really nice doggy stuff. It was just a perfect day all around, so I hope some of you were able to make it, because it really is an enjoyable day for all of us. But anyhow, this evening, since I'm still in a patriotic mood, I thought it would be nice to have the Pennsylvania State Dog on our program this evening. So my guest is Karen Lozenski and Ed Harris, and of course the breed is Great Dane. Yes, the state of Pennsylvania's state dog is a Great Dane. So suppose you tell us a little bit, by the way, before we get into the breed, when do you have any idea when the Great Dane was recognized as the state dog?
It was in the late 1800s. Oh, as far as Pennsylvania, I'm not sure, but I know they were brought over to the United States in the late 1800s.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I just wondered, with the state of Pennsylvania, you know, why they decided on, you know, the Great Dane.
I believe William Penn had Great Danes.
Okay.
I
thought, you know, well, maybe they have a Great Dane truck. What is the trucking company?
Yeah.
They had the Great Dane, and I thought, well, maybe it was made in Pennsylvania, and you know, he bought, you know, the title for the Great Danes. You know,
you will probably go back to find out somebody of influence owned one.
Yeah. That's exactly right.
That's what I think it was. I believe William Penn, I believe I've read that somewhere.
Yeah.
I never really looked into it too closely.
Right. Well, now somebody can research that in the Great Dane Club, right? But yes. I just thought, gee, it's a Pennsylvania state dog. Well, that's pretty neat. So anyhow, these are Great Danes. They came from Germany, yes?
Yes.
And they were?
They were bred to hunt wild boar and guard estates.
Oh, okay. Well, it certainly is a formidable size to guard an estate, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
I don't know anything about what they were hunting, but, you know, I guess it was a formidable host as well, right?
Yes, they hunt the wild boars, and I guess they can weigh way over like 300-400 pounds.
Really?
Mm-hmm. That's the reason for the ears.
Yes, the ears were cropped originally.
The ears were cropped so that the boar doesn't grab a hold of them and tear them.
Oh, wow.
Tradition that kept on going.
Yeah.
And
I'm sure they
crop
them
longer.
Yes, right,
they were
right.
Cropped shorter.
Right. And they weren't as pretty. I mean, they didn't have the style, I'm sure.
Right.
They were just, you know, sort of cut off before the boar ate them.
Mm-hmm.
But so what size? You have a boy and a girl here, yes?
Right.
Okay.
In our standard, the boy and the girl have a different height specification.
Okay.
The girls have to be 28 inches at the shoulder. The boys have to be 30. These are both well over that. There is no cutoff that they're too big.
Oh, okay.
There's a definite difference in the head. The girls have a little bit more of a feminine head.
Yes.
As to the boys, which he won't turn around and
show
anybody.
You're not going to see his head because he's not going to turn around. You're blending into the curtains,
yes,
hon.
She probably weighs about 130, maybe 135 pounds.
Wow.
He weighs probably about 165 pounds.
Oh, my word.
Some of them are even bigger than him.
Yeah.
So he's an average size male, but there are bigger ones.
Wow. Now, this is the color. This is what?
This
a brindle.
This is a brindle.
Okay.
This is, and this, the standard calls for it to be a base of a fawn color with the black on top, and it has to be in chevrons where they come to a point.
I didn't even notice that, to tell you the truth. How about that? Right down her back, they do.
Evenly marked, like if they're too much black or not enough black, it's a color fault.
Okay, so then they're not like some brindles you will see in other breeds. They almost look like they're tiger striped. Yes. You know, with the striping going down the sides, but they're sort of like, you know.
Yeah, it'll go to a
sprinkled.
Point, like, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're sort of like sprinkled with the black through the coat rather than, you know, a definite marking.
And our standard calls for the fawns and the brindles to have a full black mask.
Okay.
Now, the difference is that he's young, she's got the natural graying, so
okay.
They gray, and she's 9 years old, so.
Oh, okay. Well, she looks good for nine.
Yes.
it's not really a long-lived breed, is it?
No. Some of the colors live a little bit longer than others.
Really?
Yes. The blacks
tend to live
long and the Harls.
Really? Wow, that's really interesting, because not that wasn't really the main color of the Dane.
No.
You know, you're so used to seeing the Great Danes in the fawn color,
mm-hmm.
but you know, the black sort of like came along later.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
When I got in and when Karen got in, you went to a show, you only had three classes. You have fawn, you have brindle, and AOC.
Any other color.
Oh, okay.
And then the group started to pick at the AKC, and the blacks got their own group, Harls got their own, and whatnot.
Yeah.
But they were all lumped together before.
Wow.
And now we're up to seven acceptable colors.
Oh, my word.
Or patterns, I guess you would call
it. So they don't come in white, though, right?
No. White are generally deaf and blind.
Oh, really? Wow.
So, no, you don't. They have to have color somewhere on them.
Uh-huh.
Damn.
I don't think I've ever seen a white one.
Oh. No.
They're there. In the Harl breedings, they do get them occasionally, and then they have to have them tested and make sure that they can hear.
Yes. Yes. So, wow. Isn't that interesting?
I think the hearing is probably the biggest issue.
Yeah.
So, the hearing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not a Harl breeder, so I'm
certainly
not an expert on it. So
then you don't breed the colors together?
No, there is somewhat of a code of ethics as to what to breed to what. Little bit lenient on that right now, but when we first started out, it was very, very
strict.
Mm-hmm. And in fact, to enter in our national futurity, you had to be five generations color pure, and that is no longer.
Oh, wow.
So.
Wow. Do you find that if you bred color, or is that what they were finding, that if you bred color pure, that you were getting more defects?
No, I think it was just, I think that, I don't think the fawn and brindle colors breed as much, but the other colors, they'll breed into the fawn or the brindle because, for the head. They're looking for the head because
okay.
In our standard, it's very specific. They have to have two planes. They have to be parallel, and their side planes are supposed to be flat, and it's basically two boxes, you know, front and back.
Like
it's supposed to be the same distance from here to the stop, from the stop to the back.
Yeah.
So a lot of times they were breeding the different colors to improve the head.
Okay.
So
then at this point it's acceptable.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not necessarily good, but acceptable.
I mean, there's pros and cons on it. That could be a discussion.
That's exactly right. It can be a discussion all by itself.
I breed fawn to brindle. I don't do any intercolor breeding, and that's my preference.
Right,
and,
right.
You know, I'm not going to tell somebody what they can do and what they can't
exactly
do.
That's exactly right.
I know what I do,
Yeah. So how popular is this breed? I mean, you don't really see them very often walking around the streets. Obviously, it's not a breed for everyone.
I think they're fairly popular. I think right now, because there's been like program, you know, dogs on TV, you know how that goes. They see one on TV and then everybody has to have one. I would say right now the Harls are more popular than what the fawns and brindles are.
Oh.
I mean, I never have any problems, you know, like people are always calling me asking for puppies, so
Well, I guess the Harls are probably flashier.
They can be,
yeah. But you know, I guess it's what you like.
Yeah.
I like the finished eye and a finished nose, and you see so many of them that don't have the all black nose or the complete eye rim.
Right.
You know, that to me, I don't like that. So, but anyhow, so the temperament on these guys, they seem to be fairly easygoing.
When they first came over from Europe, they actually had a disposition problem, and the first year at Westminster, they were banned. But everybody, I think, over the years has bred for temperament. I know myself, I would never breed a dog that didn't have a good temperament.
Right.
I've put quite a few in homes with kids. He does nursing home visits.
Uh-huh.
I've taken many of mine to nursery schools.
Mm-hmm,
daycares, and I don't even have any children at home. They seem to adapt to the kids pretty easily. I've never had a disposition problem, but you can with any dog, but
right,
for the
right.
most part, they call them gentle giants, and they are. And I mean, they're puppies for 2 years, but after they get to be 2 years old, they calm down and they turn into big giant couch potatoes.
But I guess it's probably with a lot of the big breeds, especially the giant breeds, they still have a puppy brain, but they're this size.
Right, exactly.
And people just don't understand.
I think that's the biggest problem. Like when puppies leave my house, they already know that they can't jump up. I start very young, like pushing them down, telling them no.
Right, right.
And I tell everybody, I go, you know, you have to keep in mind, this is a big animal. So if it's not acceptable as an adult,
right.
it's not acceptable as a puppy.
Right.
And, you know, don't ever let, like everybody wants to know how tall they are. They want them to put their paws on your shoulders. Well, that's the worst thing you want them to do.
Right.
Because they're going to do it to somebody and knock them over. Or, you know, grandma comes to visit and they decide they're going to jump up on grandma.
Right, right, right.
So I basically, when they leave my house, I already have them trained. And I tell them, you just have to follow through. If you don't follow through, don't call me and tell me the dog knocked grandma over. But basically, you know, that's how I train mine. They always have to have all 4 feet on the ground.
Right, right.
If they want a cookie, right. they have to stand and wait for it. You know, we just don't allow any jumping up.
Right, right. I assume that obedience training is a must with these guys.
I would highly recommend it. If you don't know how to train them, take them to obedience. Take them somewhere where they learn simple things like stand, stay.
Yes, yes.
You know, lay
and
down.
As puppies, because they're going to grow fast.
Exactly.
So you get them into a puppy class.
Right. At 8 weeks old, most of them are going to be at least 25 pounds.
Yeah.
So you're looking at a big puppy.
Yes. Yes, you are looking at a big puppy. So I think you brought some pictures along.
I did.
So then we can see what the heck we... Oh, that's such a good picture of him. Okay. You want to explain
this
what we're looking at
this
here?
This is a six-week-old puppy. And
okay.
you can see how big their feet are.
Yes.
And so that's 6 weeks old. That's before they got their ears cropped.
Uh-huh.
And as you can see, they're born with, and this is 8 weeks or 12, this might be a little bit older, like 10 weeks
yeah.
after the ears are cropped. That happens to be this girl's three puppies.
Oh, okay. Wow, three different colors.
Well, there's two brindles and a fawn.
And a fawn. Okay, okay. Okay.
And then that happens to be the... That's a fawn male, and he's a big boy, and he happens to be the one that was in the last picture, the puppy. And that's,
oh my
this
word.
Is a full-grown fawn Great Dane.
Yeah, he's already up to the judge's waist, or above the waist.
Yeah,
I mean,
he's at least 37 inches at the shoulder.
Wow, that's a lot of dog. That's a lot of dog.
This is another example of a fawn dog. This is an adult.
Okay. What is that over his back?
He has, she's Celtic,
yeah.
she's Scottish, so she has his colors.
His coat of arms.
Yes, basically.
Isn't that neat?
He won at a big show.
So. Okay, okay, yeah.
Okay, now here is another example. The fawn is the male, and the one... the brindle is a female, and you can see the difference
yes,
in the size.
Yes, the girls definitely look like girls, and the boys look like boys.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And that fawn, that brindle is also her daughter.
Oh, okay, okay.
Now that's an example of a black, and
wow.
they have to be solid black, Occasionally, they'll have a little white on their chest, but it's definitely not desirable. They're to be solid black and true black.
Okay.
Like no undercoat color coming through or anything.
Well, now, do they bronze out if you keep them in the sun too long?
They can.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
They can.
But I guess they don't come in brown, do they?
No.
No.
Okay.
This is a blue, and they're supposed to be like a steel blue color.
Okay.
And you'll get those, you can breed with the blacks. And again, they're supposed to be solid, no white anywhere on them.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, you say it's blue, but it's, you know, it's gray.
This is a brindle male. Again, that's Ed with him.
Yeah.
That's one of ours.
Oh, okay. Okay.
This is this one's son, another brindle male.
Uh-huh.
And he's probably 37 inches at the shoulder because the woman showing him is probably close to 6 foot, Colleen.
Yeah.
Wow.
She's tall.
It's interesting, you know, seeing the dogs in person, you see a picture of them, you say, oh yeah, that's a big dog, but you know, I live in an apartment and I'm sure it'll be fine.
Actually, I had one in an apartment when I was in college.
Really?
They actually will adapt to your lifestyle.
Yeah.
They're very people oriented. They love to go anywhere you go.
Uh-huh.
And that's the biggest problem. People buy big dogs and then they don't socialize them.
Oh,
this
okay.
is another brindle bitch. This
okay.
is, happens to be her daughter.
Okay.
And like we take ours everywhere. This is an example of a Harl.
Okay, okay. So they can have big patches like that,
yes,
like on his
they
shoulder?
Yes, can. It's okay. not necessarily desirable, but it is acceptable as long as it's black.
Okay, okay. It can't be any other color then?
It shouldn't be.
Okay.
They can have a merle spot here and there, but basically they should all be black.
Okay, and merle is the black and white mix, so it looks
yes.
like a grayish spot.
Yes.
Okay, okay.
This is a example of a mantle.
Uh-huh.
This is one of the newer colors that was added.
Okay.
They're to have all four white feet, a white chest, and usually it goes white around the neck, a
uh-huh.
white foreface, and a white tip on their tail.
Oh.
So basically it's the same coloring that you would see on a Boston Terrier.
Okay.
In
okay.
fact, they wanted to call
them
Boston.
They used to call them Boston.
Boston Terrier group said no.
I don't think so, right.
So that's what's considered a mantle.
Okay.
This is a merle. Whoops. What happened? We went real fast.
Yeah.
That's a merle mantle. That is the newest addition. They're allowing the merle mantle. They have a gray coat and they have the same markings as the mantle with the white feet, the white tip,
yes.
the white front.
Uh-huh.
But on the gray section, they must have black spots.
Oh. Okay.
No, and it is in capital letters in our room.
Oh.
So they must have black spots.
Yeah, yeah. But so, they don't have all merle color then?
They do show them as well. They show them in the merle class, but basically
okay.
it's the merle mantle that you see the most of.
Okay, okay, okay.
And there's another example of a merle mantle.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Well, it is sort of striking.
Yeah, they're pretty.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then that is a six-month-old puppy, first show, and you can see the movement.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And that is a blue, is that the one that's uncropped, I believe? That's an
yes.
uncropped
yes.
blue male.
Right, you can see. They say uncropped, it's a hanging ear. The ear
yeah.
is naturally yeah. falls down like that, right?
Right, they did not have it cut.
Yeah.
Because the standard says you can show them either way.
Yeah. I think a number of breeds are going that way, and I think they do that in Europe as well.
Europe,
I don't think there's
yeah, some countries in Europe you cannot crop
right,
at all.
Right, right.
Because
yeah,
I've said
England, you're not
yeah.
allowed.
Right, right,
yeah.
right.
And this is an example of an
oh, that's a good close-up.
Fawn.
Yes, yes.
And as you can see, their ears are pretty big.
Yes, the ears are pretty big. Yes.
And they should lay like that, right next to the head.
Okay, framing the face.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And yeah. there we have.
Yes,
Mr.
our
I'm
boy.
Bored.
Yes, yes, yes. So there's nothing else to do. We may as well take a nap. But, yeah, but they are very quiet.
Yeah,
they really are.
Quiet. Yeah, I mean they like to go with you. I mean
yeah.
we've taken ours on vacation.
Hotel rooms where they have the 25 pound or less.
We never tell unless they ask.
Yes.
But I've done, you know, like I've done a lot of traveling and I use mm-hmm. Airbnb, and I usually ask, I tell them that they're crate trained mm-hmm. and that they will mm-hmm. never be left alone mm-hmm. and they go with us everywhere. And I've never had any problems. You know, I just make sure I clean up after them and I don't make a mess.
Right.
My one boy actually went on the ferry boat to Monhegan Island in Maine.
Oh, my.
And he had to walk a plank to get off the boat to get on the island. And he did it because he wanted to be with
me. That's exactly right.
And
they trust you so much that, you know, if you say, let's do it, the dog says, well, okay, you know. If you want to go, I'll go too.
He was quite the hit because mm-hmm. he was out on the front of the boat and his ears were flapping in the wind.
My. Now, as far as grooming, because it's a short coat, that doesn't necessarily mean you don't have any grooming.
Right. I mean, they need to be brushed like any other dog. Like mm-hmm. right now, these guys are shedding because they're nervous.
Yes.
And dogs will do that.
Yes.
They basically, we call them wash and wear dogs. You can just wash them and, mm-hmm. you know, brush them and, you know, just I do their toenails. Mm-hmm, they don't mm-hmm. require a whole lot of maintenance.
Right.
And they don't.
But you do have hair in the house.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
And you probably also don't have very many knickknacks sitting around either.
No, their tails kind of make everything into a hockey puck.
Yes.
We had a friend that we met up in Canada fishing that lived in Virginia, and we were coming back from the Florida circuit.
Uh-huh.
And then we decided to stop and pay them a visit, so we pulled in the driveway, went in their house, and all we saw was knickknacks all over the place.
Oh,
dog went over, sniffed each one, turned around and laid down.
Oh, wow.
You were lucky.
Yes. Yes, you're very lucky, right?
Oh, what?
Right.
And beings are tall, you know, if you don't watch, they will table surf.
Of course, they will they don't even have to reach. No. You know, they don't even have to reach.
So, like,
but
if you
can see how loving they are. I mean, look at him, you know, and that's not even his dog.
Oh, he just got back from, 2 weeks?
Yeah, he just spent 2 weeks with them.
Oh, on vacation.
Yeah.
Okay.
And at nighttime, I'll sit on the couch and he'll come get up and lay his head on my lap.
Yeah, yeah. And they are known as leaners, correct?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Right. And they love to lay on, they do not really prefer to lay on the floor. They love to lay on a couch or a big pillow.
Okay.
Or, you know, they really like to be up high.
Yes.
And,
so you have the dog sofa and you have your sofa.
Exactly.
Right. So now, would you recommend this dog for an older couple?
As long as they are, you know, if the dog is trained and they can handle, you know, the dog,
mm-hmm.
I mean, they could, I mean, if they're frail and, you know, or they have a falling issue, I would say no.
Right.
But once they're trained, I mean, basically I could walk, I wouldn't even have to put the leash on. She would just walk on my left hand side and wouldn't leave me.
Right.
And you know, he still pulls a little bit, but you know, he's
I just wondered
it
if,
all
you
depends
know.
On the training. And I think that, you know, they're pretty easy going, and we have, I mean, quite a few people I know that are older that do have them, and they don't have any issues with them.
Right.
Because I know I had bad knees for many years, and I fell a couple times outside, and my big old boy would come over and stand there, and he would actually let me use him to get myself up.
Right.
You know, like he knew that I needed
that's
his help.
Yeah, that's exactly right. So what about health problems with this breed?
Probably the biggest issue with them is they can have congenital heart problems.
Okay.
And the bloating, where the stomach actually torsions and flips, but most vets anymore do the prophylactic surgery.
Oh, okay.
They do a gastropexy where they actually go in and they just attach the stomach to the sides of the abdomen, and they can't flip. They can still blow up with air, which can be extremely uncomfortable.
Yes,
but they don't flip.
Okay.
They have done a lot of research on it, and there's a lot of different feelings of why it happens, but they've never been able to produce it.
Yes.
They do know that it does tend to run in lines.
Yes.
And they kind of think it might be due to the actual flora, like the different flora that they have in their stomachs.
Okay.
because they have, I actually was involved with a research project a couple of years ago out in Washington State. I sent, because I had four generations at my home, I was able to send blood work, saliva samples, and all sorts of different samples out to them.
Yeah, that's great.
There, in that particular study, they determined that certain dogs had the same flora, and they were had a higher tendency to have this bloating occur.
Wow, so, that's really interesting.
But
I know they
again,
always,
you know,
yeah.
I don't.
They always said, well, it's a big dog, so you definitely have to feed them raised, you know, on a raised platform. And now they're finding out, no, you shouldn't have.
And it also has something to do with the structure of the dog themselves.
Okay.
Any dog that's very deep-chested and has the tuck up has a higher tendency. I mean, Chihuahuas can bloat.
Yes,
you know, I
that's
mean,
right. Any dog can bloat.
It's just that because that's the standard, the big chest and, the, you know.
Right. Whoops. So,
somebody moving, huh?
We have an audience, you know. When you have an audience out front that stops at the front window, you know, the dogs are going to let you know that there's somebody out there that shouldn't be. What about hip dysplasia? They don't have hip dysplasia.
They can, but I think for the most part, most people get them X-rayed.
Yes, and, so that you know you're not breeding into it.
I mean, I've been breeding them since 1988, and I have not had one that's come back that's had hip dysplasia.
Right.
And everyone that I've had OFA'd has come back good or better. So
yes.
I mean, I feel hip dysplasia can be hereditary, but it can also be from a fall or something that occurred as a puppy.
That's exactly right.
So there's so many variables. It's hard to.
Well, it's just like with us. I mean, it's just like with us.
Right.
You know, yes, you have good genetics, but something might happen that creates a problem. You fall down the steps, you break a leg. Well, you know as you get older, you're going to have problems.
Exactly.
You know you're going to have problems. Arthritis is going to set in. And it's the same with the dogs.
And these dogs, you know, they're as puppies, they're clumsy.
Oh, yes, I can imagine with those big feet.
Oh, yes.
But, you know, it's a wonderful reason to get a dog from a reputable breeder, because you know you've health tested all of the dogs and you have many generations, and you take the dog back if it's not working out. You go to somebody you found on the internet or somebody you found with a sign on the road, and you have no idea what you're getting. And you say health testing, oh yeah, they're healthy. Hello, you go to a used car dealer and they say, oh yeah, this is a great car. Are you going to believe them? You know, I'm sorry. I want to see the paperwork, and I want to see the paperwork on the dogs as well. I want to know that what I'm getting is definitely what I'm getting, and that it's going to be guaranteed in some way, shape, or form. So, yes, it's a wonderful reason, especially if you want a giant breed like this. Again, not the dog for everyone. I assume you don't have any slobber problem, though, right?
And there again, there.
So with that, we'll say good night. Good night for this evening. Bye-bye.
About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.